Okay, so I received the things that I need to be able to do my DIY. So I've got some Angelus leather paints here in black and in vachetta. I've got the acrylic finisher. I also have the leather preparer, which is essentially a really strong acetone. I bought two acrylic paints, which I intended to use for the zippers. I don't know if that's gonna work. I might have to do some scraping of whatever is on the studs, like, because they're all like tarnishing. So I wonder if I use the acetone on it, will it get removed, and would I be able to paint over it? And I've got my mixing bowl, and as you can see here, I've already started with this fake Louis Vuitton. So I bought this. It cost me quite a bit for a fake. To be honest, it was like $85 for this fake. Anyway, the intention is, because I still do like the leather and the inside is actually quite nice, but I don't really like the really loud monogram effect on it, especially since it's quite obvious that it's fake. So I am actually going to be removing that white thing. So I've deglazed this already with acetone. There's still a little bit of it left, but I don't really want to use too much of it, especially because I really need to probably use gloves, because otherwise I think my skin would get really irritated. But yeah, I've done that on both sides. Now my intention is to paint the white area or the colorful area with the vachetta paint, and then paint the vachetta colored ones with black. I'm still thinking about whether I should do it that way or the other way around, wherein the vachetta will remain as a vachetta and then the colorful area would be black. We'll see how it goes. Alright, so as you can see here, I've finished a few coats off the vachetta, and I've also done the black. I was thinking initially that I wasn't going to paint the studs black, but it actually turned out really nice. So I'm just going to continue to do that. It's drying off the first coat. I think this 1.5. As you can see here, there's still quite a bit that I need to do, but that's okay because I can also see that I've like missed some spots or may have overpainted some spots. So I'm gonna do another coat of the vachetta anyway to get that black out of there. But so far it's looking good. On the other side, you see it here. There we go. So it's kind of looking like one of those Valentino stud shoes, isn't it? Okay. I'm gonna do another coat of the black on the handles and on the pocket outside. And then I am going to do another coat of the vachetta just to even out everything, especially the edges, because it still kind of shows the original color. And then what I'll probably do is go over with acetone the hardware so that whatever paint is on there would be removed. And I don't know if I'm going to go ahead, and if the acetone works to remove the old paint, then I probably will go in with a gold metallic with a little mix of copper to change the color of the hardware, but we'll see how it goes. Okay, so overnight I had applied this Angelus acrylic finisher. over the paint that has already dried for the whole day. So overnight I had that on the rest of the bag, and then this morning I had to prop up the handles using two chopsticks joined together so that I can apply the sealant as well, and that it doesn't touch any of the other parts of the bag. So it's coming together, it's looking really nice. And because this Vachetta shade is more of like a honey, like a tan, I'm thinking I will apply it to my authentic Alma bag, because my Alma bag seems to have got some water stains on it. So I'm thinking that I am going to use this on the handles and on the base. Okay, so this is almost done, but I did notice something as I was finalizing everything. This came off. It is now obvious that the stitching is just a decoration, it's not really stitched together. So just a word of warning, if you are buying replicas, this is what you are paying for. Okay, so I'm going to try and fix that with this what's it called, Celis shoe fix, which is for leather. So I'm gonna go ahead and apply some of this, and hopefully that brings them back together, because there's a little bit of stitching there, those two ends, so that it doesn't come off, but I don't want it to get ruined later on and waste all of the hard work that I've put into this.